from the equation, we differentiate square root 3x plus 1 to 3x plus 1 power of 1 over 2. Then, bring up 3x plus 1 power of 1 over 2 and differentiate, we'll get 3 bracket negative 1 over 2 bracket 3x plus 1 bracket power of negative 3 over 2 bracket times 3. Differentiate 3x plus 1 to get 3. 3 times 3 is 9. Then, solve by 9 times negative 1 over 2, we'll get negative 9 over 2 bracket 3x plus 1 bracket power of negative 3 over 2. Rearrange by bring down 3x plus 1 power of negative 3 over 2 to change the power to positive. The answer is negative 9 over 2 bracket 3x plus 1 bracket power of 3 over 2. We will use product rule. First, differentiate u and v to get u prime and v prime. U is x power of 4. Differentiate, we will get 4x power of 3 for u prime. Next, v is 2x minus 5. Differentiate, we will get 2 for v prime. Then, substitute all the values into the equation uv prime plus vu prime. After that, expand the values, we will get 2x power of 4 plus 8x power of 4 minus 20x power of 3. Solve it and the answer is 10x power of 4 minus 20x power of 3.
This question 1c, we need to identify either we need to use product rules or question rules. But for this question, we need to use a question rule. First of all, we need to state that 2 plus 3x as a u and 3x, 3 minus x the power of 3 as a v. After that, we're going to differentiate both of them to get the u prime and v prime. After that, we will use formula v u prime minus u v prime over v2, v the power of 2, and substitute the value inside the formula. And lastly, simplify the equation and we will get the answer.
For this question, we need to use product rule formula, which is dy over dx equal uv prime plus vu prime. So in this question, u is x to the power of 3 and v is 2x plus 5 to the power of 2. So u is x to the power of 3. We need to differentiate it and we'll get 3x to the power of 2. And we need to differentiate v also, which is 2x plus 5 squared. But first, we need to expand it first. And we'll get 8x plus 20. And then we'll use a product rule equation, which is dy over dx equal to uv prime plus vu prime. So we'll get dy over dx equal to x to the power of 3, 8x plus 20 plus 4x squared plus 20x plus 25 times 3x squared. And then we need to use product rule formula, which is dy over dx equal to uv prime plus vu prime. So we'll get dy over dx, x to the power of 3 times 8x plus 20 plus 4x squared plus 20x plus 25 times 3x squared. And then we simplify it. We'll get 5x squared times 2x plus 5 times 2x plus 3. And from that equation, we need to substitute 1 into x. Then we'll get dy over dx equal to 5 times 1 to the power of 2, 2 times 1 plus 3, and 2 times 1 plus 5, and then we get 175.
I love more!
For the first Roman, 2 value of x and y if the midpoint of the straight line AB is 4, 9 over 2. So for this question, we will use the midpoint formula, which is m x y equals to x2 plus x1 over 2 and y2 plus y1 over 2. We just insert the number that is given based on their coordinates, so we get 4, 9 over 2 equals to x plus 3 over 2, 2 plus y over 2. First, we need to find x. We get 4 equals to x plus 3 over 2. We move 2 to the left and it will be times, so 2 times 4 we get 8. It will be 8 equals to x plus 3. And then we move 3 to the left, so it will be 8 minus 3 equals to x, so we get x equals to 5. Next, we will solve y. 9 over 2 equals to 2 plus y over 2. 2 we move to the left and we get 9 equals to 2 plus y. And then we move to 2 to the left and we get 9 minus 2 and we get y equals to 7. The answer for this is x equals to 5 and y equals to 7. For 2 Roman, so the points will be a 3, 5 and b 7, 2. We will use the distance formula, which is square root in bracket x2 minus x1 squared plus in bracket y2 minus y1 squared. And then we just insert the number. We will get square root in bracket 7 minus 3 squared plus in bracket 2 minus 5 squared. And we solve this and get square root 16 plus 9. 16 plus 9 equals to 25, so we get square root 25. And after we square root 25, we will get the answer is 5.
Proceed to the next question. First, by the given information, we need to substitute the 2 points given into the gradient formula to find its gradient, which is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. In this case, y2 is 6, y1 is 2, x2 is 5, x1 is negative 3. Then, we substitute the answer to the straight line equation, which is y equal to mx plus c. We can choose one point, either point P or point Q, to substitute into the equation to find c. In this case, I chose point Q, which is y equals to 6 and x equal to 5. After we get c, we write the straight line equation by substitute c with 7 over 2 as the final answer.
First, we must know that the multiplication of two perpendicular lines is equal to negative 1. First, we need to find the gradient of line A. The formula is m1 times m2 equals to negative 1. We need to substitute the gradient of line PQ into the formula. And then, the value of m2 is equal to negative 2. This is the gradient for line A. Next, we need to find the value of y-intercept. So, we need to substitute the coordinate of x-intercept into the straight line equation. The equation would be 0 equals to negative 2 times 2 plus c. So, the value of c is equal to 4. The straight line equation of a is y equals to negative 2x plus 4.
For this equation 3v3, it's kind of straightforward, which is we just going to use formula y equal to mx plus c. We just substitute the value of gradient, which is m, we already got from last equation, 1 over 2 inside the formula, and the c, which is we already know. If it passes through the point of origin, the y-intercept is 0, so we just substitute the value inside the formula. So we're going to get y equal to 1 over 2x minus 0, but if the value is 0, we're just going to use y equal to 1 over 2x.